长达9个月没有全国性防疫计划。美国11月19号，6个月来最黑暗的一天。单日新增确诊人数不但已经连续10天每天破10万人，大选后疫情更失控为单日破18万例，是夏季疫情的整整2倍。
More than 2,015 Americans lost their lives just yesterday. That's the most in a single day since May.
11月18号，全美死于新冠病毒的人数已正式超过25万人。等于死亡人数再度回升为每日平均逾1000人的恐怖水平，累计全美确诊人数已经上看1190万人，等于每4人就有约1人感染。
How far do you think you are from the breaking point?
We've had a day last week where we were down to 1 ventilator.
I'm extremely worried. This is a worst case scenario. We have the holidays here at a time when respiratory viruses thrive. They love cold weather, they love low humidity. And we have a nation that has not come together around what needs to be done to control this.
惊人的是，最近这100万人的感染只花了6天，前一个100万人感染却花了整整98天。病毒交叉感染更快，全美几乎50周都感染剧增。但仍有许多美国人认为疫情是骗局，动辄在重症病房辱骂医护。
Too many people still seem to think that COVID-19 is a hoax, or that a disease that is killing 1,500 Americans per day isn't worth any effort to stop.
I still hear people saying that COVID-19 isn't real, that it's just another cold.
I don't need your instruction from...
I know you don't need my instruction, but there clearly isn't much interest in this body in public health. We have a president who hasn't shown up at the coronavirus task force meeting in months.
政治操弄使得疫情失控，全美超过20多州重新定各自展开最严格的限制措施。加州每日新增攀升达10,000人，增长4倍。州长紧急宣布，自周六晚间起到12月21号强制实施宵禁令。纽泽西州州长下令，11月17号后，室内与室外聚集人数皆禁止超过10人。而曾经是全美最严重的纽约，由于纽约市的检测阳性率上升至超过3%，市长下令19号起，公立学校与幼儿园暂时关闭，全改为线上授课。上班族家庭一时措手不及，州议会交相指责授权的纽约州长。
That's the law, an orange zone and a red zone. Follow the facts.
I'm confused, and
then I'll tell you what you mean.
Parents are still confused as well. The schools
are confused. No, they're not confused. You're confused.
所有预测模型皆指向红灯结果。终于让抗拒口罩令数月的爱荷华州共和党籍州长宣布踩刹车。
If you can't social distance and you're going to be in a prolonged interaction with an individual for more than 15 minutes, then you're required to wear a mask. That's what's in the proclamation. That's the expectation. So I'm asking Iowans again, it's not where we want to be, but we need everybody to step up and do the right thing.
一件对的事，居然拖延抗拒9个月之久。爱荷华州共和党最资深参议员87岁的格拉斯利也宣布确诊。他是美国第三顺位总统继承者，但同为共和党籍州长执政的南达科他州，检测阳性率高达55%，已是全美第二高。州长仍坚持不实施口罩令。
My people are happy. They're happy because they're free.
不自由，难道真的无宁死吗？纽约时报警告，美国每日死于新冠人数将很快从现今的每天1000人恶化为每天2000人以上。
This will get worse. We have had 1 million cases documented over the past week. Unfortunately, we do anticipate this to continue, at least for the next couple of weeks.
美国的问题在于，各州各自为政，放任防疫破口扩大，而中央防疫混乱陷入空窗。 联邦政府在川普拒绝承认败选，拒绝进行交接，白宫防疫小组被爆出长达五个月没开会后，才在11月20号匆匆进行记者会。但是副总统潘斯虚话如常。
I believe the day is coming soon when we will put this coronavirus in the past.
But President Trump's coronavirus advisor, radiologist Dr. Scott Atlas, suggested on Twitter people should, quote, rise up against those restrictions.
What the hell's the matter with these guys?What is the matter with them? Resist.
挫折与愤怒全写在脸上。纽约时报透露，由于拜登新政府团队被禁止与负责分发疫苗的官员交接，不但现阶段的抗疫措施严重热区和病例死亡数或住院率等数据无法取得，就连意外现身于周四记者会上任美国传染病研究所主任的佛奇也不得与拜登团队接触。
I would wish that we would be able to do that. That would be helpful.
且下一阶段两支研发成功的辉瑞与 Moderna 疫苗防疫力都在90%以上，辉瑞也将在周五申请紧急授权，预估今年年底完成审批开始分发。而美国卫生部也正全力制定关键的疫苗配送计划，但这关键的疫苗站拜登团队也无法获知详情。
By the end of December, we expect to have about 40 million doses of these two vaccinesavailable for distribution, pending FDA authorization. Enough to vaccinate about 20 million of our most vulnerable Americans.
Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar refusing today to acknowledge a Biden transition is even underway.
Once GSA determines that there is, if there is a transition to do, we will ensure that it's cooperative and professional. That determination has been made.
If we have to wait until January 20th to start that planning, it puts us behind.Over a month, month and a half. And so it's important that it be done, that there be coordination now.
相较于2016年，奥巴马立刻在选后隔天祝贺并邀请川普两日后到白宫会谈。四年后，川普在选后两周不回应国政，也禁止政权交接。奥巴马严批总统一职，非只看个人政治私利。
A president is a public servant.They are temporary occupants of the office by design. And when your time is up, then it is your job to put the country first and think beyond your own ego and your own interests and your own disappointments.
对于这位失望的总统，代表全美医护的三大医疗协会联合发表公开信，医疗单位的治疗与检测器具、个人防备、呼吸器与病床容量，这些国家资产的数据，新政府必须掌握，才能进行部署规划，挽救千万人生命。但目前为止，除了我们赢了的绯闻和寻求翻盘之外，川普对其他事务全保持沉默。大流行病毒与政治病毒同时袭向美国，影响势必非同小可。